My name is Sara Saeed. My project is Sehat Kahani. It's a health tech social enterprise that connects at-home female doctors to patients in low-income communities using telemedicine and video consultation. I think there's a very unique concept in Pakistan. It's called the Dr. Bride phenomena, that a lot of female doctors do not work after getting a professional degree and become Dr. Brides and sit at home having a family or children. The second problem that exists in our country, ironically, is that we have a huge population of 200 million people, but unfortunately, 50% of these do not get access to healthcare. 26% women never see a doctor in their pregnancy, and we lose 1 out of 5 children before their 5th birthday. So we're trying to put these female doctors back into the workforce within the cultural barriers that exist in Pakistan and connecting them to patients in very low-income and rural communities where health access is not available through technology. So we start working in the community by doing a small needs assessment. So we understand the community, its needs. Then we identify nurses in the communities who are already working and are certified by the government to provide healthcare. We then find their clinics and we upgrade its infrastructure to make sure it becomes a standardized primary healthcare center, up to medical as well as professional standards. So we put in furniture, we paint the clinic, we brand it with our logo, we put in the laptop, we put our digital e-care tools, such as a blood pressure instrument, a glucometer that checks diabetes, and an e-stethoscope. We put an internet connectivity device and electricity backup, and kind of help the nurse to provide a continuous care in our clinics. Once the clinic is upgraded, then we train the nurse on medical and pharmaceutical protocols to how to talk to a patient, soft skills that are required to make sure patient management is better, and then we train her on a software. This software consists of 2 parts. There's an EMR, so all the data of the patient gets recorded electronically, and then the patient is taken to a video consultation software where a doctor can talk to the patient, patient can share their records online, a doctor can view it, consultation can happen, examination can happen in front of the doctor when the nurse is doing it, and after the consultation, a prescription can be provided to the patient, again printed electronically with doctor's signature. And that's how the consultation process is incomplete. We also have access to labs, ultrasounds, and a tertiary care referral program in the clinics so that the clinic becomes a primary healthcare one-stop shop so that patients don't have to travel to far-off communities to get basic primary healthcare. We also do health education awareness in our communities, working with different corporates and pharmaceuticals as clinical and preventive care goes hand in hand. We also now have an application that allows people like you and me, a normal person who may have access to a doctor but is still searching for quality or affordability, to have a doctor in their phones 24/7. Telemedicine is definitely not new. I think we all have a doctor's number saved in our phones that we call in times of emergency. So what's unique is other companies provide technology. We are providing medical care as we are 2 female doctors who are working on this organization, making sure that technology is an enabler, but in the end, we can create a wholesome experience for the doctor as well as for the patient. I'm a female doctor myself, and there was a point in my life where I felt the pain of not being able to work. I had my first daughter and I moved into a new city and I gave up my work. And in those 9-10 months when I was at home with my child, I went into severe postpartum depression. And the only thing that saved me and the only thing that brought me back to being my normal self is my ability or my vision to go back to work. And since I was at home and I could do this from my home for other patients in my native city, we kind of tested it out as a pilot in one of the low-income communities where I gave consultations over a video consultation platform. And seeing that it works for 200 to 300 patients, it then generated the concept of the company that a female doctor like me sitting at home can still be useful to patients.
Number 5.
But not a lot of female doctors are privileged enough to think that. their conditions don't allow them to come back. So I think this concept came to my ex-partner and me because we wanted to do something to make sure that female doctors are going back to work. I'm a mother of two daughters. It's not easy for a woman in Pakistan to have a career and have a family. I don't want my daughters to grow up in a Pakistan where they can't work, where they have to make a choice, as most of women of my generation have. And I don't want them to be in a place where they're not healthy or their children are not healthy. So I think it's my responsibility as a mother to ensure that the country that they're growing up in provides them with adequate healthcare. And not only my children, but children that are present all over Pakistan who basically don't have the same privileges as my children do. I think it's our responsibility to make sure that they are well cared for. I think back home, back in Pakistan, being a female founder, having a female-led company, for women, by women, trying to break so many patriarchal stereotypes, I think you need all the support that you can. And being connected to an organization like Rolex just increases our credibility to tenfold and puts us on the map that we are doing this work and we're here to stay. When you walk into a community where there isn't a doctor available for 20, 30 kilometers and people have to spend half their month's earning to go to a doctor and get basic primary healthcare, when you establish a clinic there and you enable a nurse with technology so that she can connect a patient to an online doctor who's sitting in places such as Australia, Canada, somewhere in Pakistan, totally urban, I think that's the magic. When that equation comes together, that beautiful moment keeps us going every day. Ultimately, we want Sehat Kahani and its application to be present in every Pakistani's home so that whenever they need a doctor, at 12 a.m. in the morning or 3 a.m. in the morning, or if they're a nurse in a low-income community wanting to connect to a doctor, they would not have to go through a boundary of a clinic but can have a doctor in their phone 24/7. And that would be the impact of the project. I'm sure this platform can be utilized for other countries, and we want to be the provider who's providing this platform to other countries as well. A very big ambition.